seemed to be more brutal here than anywhere else. It seeped into bones and into every breath to get to the heart until it stopped. Carl needed to be dressed in warm clothes to survive.
Tu m'amènes un bon galon de caribou, puis on devient amis. Sinon, mon petit gars, tu sors pas.
There, Carl had fed his mind, but had forgotten the harsh reality that his body also needed nourishment, especially in the dead of winter. That truck had obviously seen its share of gravel roads. Carl wasn't a mechanic, but he could easily tell that only the most heartfelt prayer would bring this old beater back from its slumber. With that cold, however, it was more likely that it would wait until next spring to wake up. With a homemade shooting range such as this, it wasn't hard to imagine a stray bullet ending its course inside the flesh of an unsuspecting passerby. Granted, Carl thought, there wasn't much in the way of passersby around here. The place looked more like a pigsty than a house. A heavy stench of curdled milk, cheap alcohol, and boiled cauliflower filled the air. Back then, in Africa and elsewhere, people were ready to take up arms to stand against the yoke of English imperialism. In Montreal, mailboxes were blown up, abductions were carried out, and violent manifestos were distributed to media outlets. But around here, in the great northernmost, all a man could do is curse out loud against a faraway evil and pray for the revolution to arise. That man, by any reckoning, was from that very stock. Régin Blouin, seems like that pig had a name after all. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. Carl now knew how to quench the drunkard's thirst. You had to be out of your mind to cook up white whiskey at home. The all-surrounding stench of alcohol alone was probably enough to gas a man to death. Rock music invaded the minds of men even in the remotest of places. The man didn't own a turntable, though, so there's that going for him. If Carl had at any point wished to get his hands on some caribou, he couldn't have wished for better than a distillery like this one.
Oh, God.
It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Sometimes, and especially around here, people are so possessive with their land, as a dog is with hydrants. What good was a motorless car? The mechanic sure had an odd way to go about repairing things. Well, this truck's not going anywhere. Where were the amputated parts? Carl grinned as he pictured a Frankenstein-esque car lying around somewhere made of parts from a dozen different vehicles. Sheets of metal everywhere. Was Carl out of touch with current home improvement trends? Or perhaps this was meant to protect against residual radiation? Gamma rays? Cold turned into pain. Carl needed to find someplace warm. Perhaps someone was expecting an important call. In any case, that person's in for a long wait. Carl already noticed that telephone services weren't provided in this area. Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves? Roswell, Atamipec, same story. Large deserts conducive to extravagant follies. The man has a passion for intergalactic things. Back then, people were obviously scared of the Russian atomic bomb. But an invasion by extraterrestrials was a legit fear as well. Seems like the mechanic had made it. Carl deducted this was a map of the area. Were those pins pointing to places of interest? Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? to protect against nuclear waves? Another worrisome victim of this ice, this one seemingly petrified in action. The poor man, before being frozen solid, seemed to have been defending the entrance to his cabin. But from what? Something very important must have been in there for the man to take such time and effort to hide it. But Carl didn't know how to reach it. The very first steps of man on the moon were made more than a year ago. The event had surely captivated the mechanic's mind for him to still keep this around. To all appearances, Carl concluded, the owner of the place had moved more essentials from his house inside the garage. Peculiar man indeed. Thank you. The week of October 5th, thought Carl. That was this week. The plug should have been here by now. Indisputable fact that machines like this entailed a level of intellectual finesse that Carl was lacking. Following the plan, Carl was led to believe that the snowmobile's parts had to be scattered about in the vicinity. Carl hadn't lived up to his good finder reputation. He still hadn't found any of the wealth contained in Lamotte's lands. The milk was sorted by color, from the whitest to the greenest, or in other words, from the freshest to the sourest. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.
A bit of gas, a new spark plug, and a key, and this thing would run perfectly. All he needed to do now was to find all that. Weird stuff. Kind of a crossing between a colander and a hairdryer. What was it for? To play telepath? To protect against nuclear waves? If some daring person could manage to get their hands on the missing parts, Carl was willing to bet that the craft would have taken flight. These scribblings were undoubtedly the mark of a tormented mind. Something wasn't right in the poor mechanic's head.
large antenna in the middle of the path. Undoubtedly ideal in attempting to communicate with little green men, was quite awkwardly placed. There had to be a lever to control it, maybe behind it. Carl would have to figure out how to reach it. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. The machine seemed to work. Carl sent out an SOS. No reply. The electric terminals appeared to be linked together, but for what purpose? Carl rejoiced at the unexpected source of heat, but not as much as his freezing hands. It was so cold, already Carl did not feel his toes anymore.